capability 30 days risk-free today. TFNN, educating investors.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
This is awesome. Comment allez-vous? We're going over to Paris. What's happening?
Hey, Tom. It's Adam from Paris. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great, Adam. Yourself?
That's good. Long time no talk. I appreciate everything you've done for me and my family over the years. So,
well, we appreciate you growing one problem with us.
Yeah, sir. I've done the gold report and all the softwares and all your books and read it. Generational thank you.
You are. Seminars. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Good afternoon, everybody. Tommy O'Brien coming to you live from TFNN, 3:07 p.m. Eastern Time on Fed Day, and I come to you with markets at record price territory right now. We're talking about an S&P. At 52.81, we were just airing Chairman Powell's press conference. He's wrapping that up as we speak, and the market's liking what they are hearing right now. You talk about an acceleration, man. S&Ps right now. We've got a lot to cover this afternoon, folks. Stay with us. S&Ps right now up by 40. Nice round number. 40 points to the positive side. 52.82 up by about 0.75%. NASDAQ 100, you talk about a lift, man. We were higher on the announcement at 2 p.m. Eastern time. Yet a little bit of a recoil. Chairman Powell comes on the air at 2:30 p.m. Eastern time, and we get a little bit of an acceleration. NASDAQ 100 up 194 points, 1.07% in the positive. Dow, check it out. Are we going to hit 40,000? You need my chart. Shame on me. Here we go. It's coming. Better get that chart. We got so much going on. Thank you to my producers. There's your chart. I better get it up there before we hit 40,000 in the Dow. Dow right now up 358 points. That's 0.9% in the positive. Futures trading at 39,905. First time I've ever said 39,900 on the air live. You talk about it. It's going to be an interesting hour, folks. Markets digesting a Fed decision. They leave interest rates exactly where they were. That was to be expected. We have a target range of 5.25% to 5.5%. But everything had to do with the forecast, folks. They are still looking at, they are still looking at three cuts this year. Part of the story, though, is that what do? They take one cut out of the dot plot next year. You're talking about 3.9 versus a 3.6 previously. And the long-term benchmark rate has been adjusted higher. That might be the biggest story of this announcement, of this press conference. They adjust the benchmark rate to 2.6%, that from 2.5%, seems like we're probably not going back to the interest rates that we had at one point. And that could just be the first time, folks. When I was doing the program live at 2 o'clock, coming on the air before Chairman Powell was talking at 2:30, you know, if you think about it, right, if the Fed has to adjust and inform the market that they are making a pretty substantial change, if they're adjusting their longer-term rate of where they may end up, they're not going to do it to a drastic degree if they don't have to. And they don't have to right now. They have some room. They're still sitting at 5.25% to 5.5%. The long-term rate is years out from where we are right now. We're at 5.25% to 5.5% right now. Okay? They're going to slowly adjust that. And I think this might be the first one in terms of where you come in. The market nonetheless reacting. And we got S&Ps to higher prices, man, up by 40 points to 52.82. As I mentioned, we might get 40,000 Dow. As I speak, folks, pretty remarkable. Quite a day, and we got 50 minutes left of trading. And as we know, it's always a wild one on Fed Day, to say the least. We check in on yields. Now, what's so interesting here is that, first of all, the conversation had to do with maybe we get the dot plot showing only two cuts this year. That's not the case, okay? They leave it at three. We'll see where we go. Chairman Powell, he kicked off the press conference saying they still feel it will be appropriate at some time this year to cut. While they're leaving themselves some room, the market thinks that's going to begin in June. They have three dot plots out there for in terms of where they're going to cut. But one thing you want to look at is that 9 of the 19 members of the Federal Open Market Committee see that number as two or less. Yeah, you have two members in there, I believe, at zero cuts. You got another two members in there, I think, at one cut. And then you have in there on top of it another four, I believe, or five in there at two cuts. So there is some disagreement of whether we get those three cuts. We will find out, folks. You jump over to the dollar index. There you go, right? So what do we have? We got the dollar. You talk about a pullback, man. On the heels of that press conference, it spikes at 2:35 p.m. Eastern time. You accelerate to lower price. You got the dollar going from 103.90 to 103.45. That is a move, folks, and that is going to move some commodities, as you may expect. Check out the gold contract, 21.89. Gold just jumps $30, man. Look at the first move, up to 21.75. You pull back to 21.65, and then boom, you take off on the press conference as well. Gold pushing 21.90. Now, all-time high on the futures, just hanging out there at 22.03. Look at that acceleration, challenging those highs. Boy, the gold stocks have been on fire recently, and we're going to have a great interview. Great day to do it, man. We have our man Elliot Wallenbach from Direction. He's going to be coming up, man, next segment. We'll talk a little bit of gold, as we got quite a day with some market action, to put it lightly. We jump over to the VIX. As expected, we take out an area of quite an economic data point, a Federal Open Market Committee decision. They leave rates where they are, and you have a VIX spiking about 14 to 13.24 as this market just creeps higher. And what is interesting here on the VIX, just on a technical perspective, right, you are breaking below kind of this trend line. Since, you know, I was talking about this on my program this morning, we made a low in the VIX of 11.81 back in December. As this market has just crushed higher, you've actually seen the VIX make a series of higher highs and higher lows. But guess what? Today might be the difference. As we are breaking lower, as this market crushes higher, we're reaching all-time highs right now, and you have the VIX trading at 13.24, down from a price of 15.53 just 5 days ago, let alone where we were. Negative action as this market, no one's going to be paying up for volatility premium when the market is just going higher on a consistent basis. Pretty remarkable. All right, jumping back to some of the cherry-picked antidotes in terms of the Fed here. I was talking about this when I was on the air at 2 p.m. Eastern time, okay? And you do want to stay on that benchmark rate, man. I know Chairman Powell was talking about it, but this is one data point I was talking about, a substantial minority. It's as large of a minority as it could be while being a minority. 9 of 19 Fed members see the Fed cutting fewer than three times this year. So you're going to hear a lot about the dot plot still maintaining three cuts this year. But keep in mind, 9 of the 19, and yes, two officials see no cuts. Two officials see one cut. Five officials see two cuts. Yeah, you got the 9 officials seeing three, okay? So 9 officials see less than two cuts. 9 officials see three cuts. And then you got one official who's up there at four cuts. So there is some disagreement among the Federal Reserve in terms of where they're going to go. And keep that in mind, because you're going to hear a lot, as I mentioned, about three cuts this year. They take one out of the picture next year. But boy, that's talking about going forward. They update the growth forecast. Not too surprising, considering the upbeat data that we've gotten recently. And yeah, this one, we got 45 minutes to go left in trading, folks. Yeah, we got a lot to talk about. We got a treat. We're coming back with Elliot Wallenbach. We'll be talking some markets. We'll talk some treasuries. We'll talk some gold. We'll talk some gold equities. Don't go away, folks. We'll be back in 3 minutes. Stay tuned.
If you spend any time online researching trading techniques on how to begin your trading journey, you've no doubt come across many folks who push Forex trading as a way to make big money quickly. Unfortunately, there are equally as many stories of these so-called Forex professionals just looking to make a quick buck off aspiring traders without actually teaching the ins and outs of the Forex market. This is what sets Teddy Keckstack's The Tiger Forex Report off the riffraff. Every Monday, former Chicago Mercantile Exchange member and author Teddy Keckstad releases his Tiger Forex Report newsletter, where he dives into the complex world of Forex and takes time to actually teach you his methods that have made him so successful in the fast-paced and rewarding world of Forex trading. Furthermore, all subscribers receive access to archived live streams of Teddy's, where he provides university-level education to help you in Forex trading. All first-time subscribers receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what are you waiting for? Forex awaits.
The stock market is a delicate interconnecting web of commodities, equities, and trader psychology. When one string of the web is pulled, it has a ripple effect across the broader market. This is where opportunity lies. But how are you to gather all of this information into one cohesive model when you're already spending your energy looking for any possible trade opportunities? Luckily, you don't have to worry about that, as Tom O'Brien has brought all important market news to you in one single newsletter, Market Insights. Market Insights provides a daily overview of what's happening in the indexes, bonds, gold, and more. Follow along with Tom daily as he analyzes the components that affect the overall movement of the stock market, giving insight into how each one plays either a bullish or bearish role. Tom also analyzes specific equities that he believes has the potential to make huge returns, and his track record proves his analysis right. All first-time subscribers receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what are you waiting for? Don't let the market leave you in the dust.
Are you ready to take charge of your financial future? TFNN is your gateway to the world of trading and investing. Whether you're starting out or scaling up, TFNN empowers traders and investors of all skill levels with top-notch investing systems, strategies, and techniques. It's time to protect and grow your money with insight you can trust. Join us live Monday through Friday during market hours for exclusive content that moves with the markets. At TFNN, we bring the trading floor to you. Our seasoned hosts are here to answer your calls and questions live on the air. Check out the Tiger's Den for just $1 and follow us on YouTube and become part of our vibrant community. And remember, at TFNN, we're so confident in the value we provide that we offer a 30-day money-back guarantee on all new premium newsletter subscriptions and services. You have absolutely nothing to risk, so why wait? Tune in live to Tiger TV and transform your trading journey, because when you know better, you invest better. Join us and experience the difference today. TFNN, educating investors.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern, for free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
In the world of trading, only a few names stand out like Larry Pesavento. A pro's pro with over 50 years of experience, Larry has seen it all. A former Chicago Mercantile Exchange member, Larry has authored 10 books and trained over 1,000 traders with his unmatched expertise. Introducing Fibonacci 24/7, Larry Pesavento's daily trading service that turns the complexity of markets into opportunities. Published every Sunday, receive a comprehensive report packed with detailed commentary, charts, and videos that illuminate the patterns shaping the markets, with updates throughout the week exclusively for subscribers. Whether through charts or videos, Larry's analysis is your roadmap to navigating the markets. You can sign up now at TFNN.com for just $97. And with all TFNN newsletters backed by a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to risk. For all the details, visit TFNN.com. You'll find Fibonacci 24/7 right under the newsletters tab.
Steve Rhodes started his trading career as a student almost 20 years ago, and the student has now become the master. Steve won the prestigious Timer of the Year award in 2018 and barely missed that mark again in 2019, finishing at number 2 for the year. An amazing accomplishment. Steve Rhodes is committed to sharing his techniques and knowledge with anyone who wants to learn, and he shares his vast amount of trading knowledge every day in his Mastering Probability newsletter. Steve's award-winning newsletter, Mastering Probability, is delivered every trading day with updates throughout the afternoon. Sign up for Steve's market newsletter, Mastering Probability, and you'll receive access to 7 of Steve's educational webinars absolutely free. At TFNN, all our newsletters come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have absolutely nothing to worry about. Visit TFNN.com and try Mastering Probability 30 days risk-free today. TFNN, educating investors.
The stock market is a delicate interconnecting web of commodities, equities, and trader psychology. When one strand of the web is pulled, it has a ripple effect across the broader market. This is where opportunity lies. But how are you to gather all of this information into one cohesive model when you're already spending your energy looking for any possible trade opportunities? Luckily, you don't have to worry about that, as Tom O'Brien has brought all important market news to you in one single newsletter, Market Insights. Market Insights provides a daily overview of what's happening in the indexes, bonds, gold, and more. Follow along with Tom daily as he analyzes the components that affect the overall movement of the stock market, giving insight into how each one plays either a bullish or bearish role. Tom also analyzes specific equities that he believes has the potential to make huge returns, and his track record proves his analysis right. All first-time subscribers receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what are you waiting for? Don't let the market leave you in the dust.
Building wealth trading in the stock market seems impossible to most people. They think it's too volatile and risky. Most people aren't going to take the time to educate themselves on how to do it right. But you're not most people, are you? At TFNN, you'll get the guidance you need to refine your strategies and techniques to invest like a pro. Because you'll be a pro. All TFNN subscriptions, books, software, and courses are available at TFNN.com. And I'm even going to tell you how to get them for less. Use TFNN's Tiger Dollars and you'll get up to a 20% bonus on your purchase. And once you apply them to your account, Tiger Dollars are automatically used for all future or recurring charges. Tiger Dollars also never expire, are fully transferable, and are a great way to add savings to your newsletters or services. Become the investor you were born to be at TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
Welcome back, folks. We got the S&Ps right now trading up 40 points. Nice round number hanging on. We're going to be at record prices, man. Pretty remarkable, and it's a great day. We got a special treat, folks. We have a guest, Elliot Wellenbach. Elliot's the Senior Vice President with Institutional ETF Strategy with Direction, and we're going to talk some markets. Elliot, welcome to TFNN. Thanks so much for joining us.
Hey, Tommy. Thank you for having me. Excited to be here.
Boy, so we spoke last week. We were talking about the interview. I was excited to have you on, and we got some fireworks today, man, as may have been the case. I know we're going to talk, you know, some treasuries. We got some action today. We'll talk a little bit of gold. But just on the first glimpse, what do you think about the Fed? All, you know, expectations are we keep it where we are, and that's what they do. We're at 5.25% to 5.5%. But yeah, the market reacting a bit as we got record prices across the board right now. We have yields reacting, and I know we'll talk some gold. You have gold spiking with the dollar kind of cratering a bit. What do you think of this market action today, Elliot?
Yeah, no, definitely an exciting day. Any day around FOMC meeting, you know, always going to be some calm before the storm. You know, nothing too unexpected that, you know, really saw coming out of, you know, having no change to current rates. And of course, once you get Powell on speaking, that's going to move the markets, which we did see, you know, broadly moving higher and sending rates lower. But that being said, I mean, there's not too much new that's come out from the rhetoric of that they still need to see greater confidence in cuts before they have cuts. And inflation is still running very hot. And they need to see that tick down. And, you know, one thing they did mention, which they have before, is, you know, if they see a weakening or continue weakening labor market, that could, you know, instill a response from them. So, you know, pretty moving markets here. And, you know, we do have ETFs for traders, short-term tactical trading, mostly in the leverage and inverse space. And we've seen a lot of traders going into, our 20 plus year bull treasury ETF TMF, which is actually a contrarian view compared to TMV, which is the inverse. So we've seen a lot of actually the largest inflows out of all of our ETFs into, the bull fund TMF on the 20 plus year treasury.
And I'm glad you went there, man, because that was going to be my first question. Yields in focus. It's Fed day. You got the chairman speaking. They adjust some of their forecasts potentially on a longer term basis. So it's interesting when you talk about maybe 20 year plus, the 30 year right now. We got actually rising in yield. The 2 year, a little bit of a different case when you look at that yield curve and how it's reacting. But if you could go into, because I know we have a ton of traders out there, treasuries are in focus, of course. And for those traders out there looking to trade potentially some of the action in treasuries, maybe they don't have a futures account where they're trading, some of these futures accounts that I'm pulling up. If you could go over, you listed them, but the TMF, I got it up here right now. You're down about 5 pennies. But for those traders, if you could go over it again, those ones in particular, for traders looking for action, when you're looking at U.S. treasuries, kind of some of the options that you guys at Direction have available for those traders.
Yeah, absolutely. We mentioned, we specialize mainly in leverage and inverse ETF short-term trading vehicles. So, as I already mentioned, TMF, that's a 20-plus year treasury bull fund. And we also have TMV, which is on the 20-plus year treasury. That's a bear fund, both 3X ETFs. So these are short-term trading vehicles. And if you're looking to trade the shorter end of the curve, we do have the 7 to 10 year bull and bear 3X products, TYD and TYO, which we've seen a fair amount of action in this year especially.
Nice. And we got to jump to gold, man. I had mentioned that, boy, we got a lot of gold bugs in the trading room over here. And I was just jumping around even to Nugget before you came on the air. Look at that chart of Nugget, folks, up 9.4%. So we have the dollar pulling back. Quite a move on the dollar, man. Even with, a great summation, not a huge surprise from the chairman or the Fed. We, they still got 3 cuts in the picture right now this year. Some adjustments later. But, boy, the dollar just pulled back earlier today from 104.15 almost. We're at 103.46. You got gold spiking near record territory, and you got Nugget, man, up almost 10%. So for traders out there, you got gold right near highs. The miners, man, sometimes they move just magnificently when you get that type of action in gold. For the traders out there looking for some action in gold in the miners, if you could go over some of the options. I know I just put one out there, but for traders putting some money out there looking for some action in the miners, the products you guys have available there as well.
Yeah, no, definitely. Yeah, gold has been hovering around, all-time highs, kind of waiting for this Fed decision. Like you mentioned, we saw a nice pop after, the announcement, and especially with the Powell rhetoric. We've seen gold miners actually move kind of lagging behind gold. Of course, these gold mining ETFs, they're invested in equities and not in spot gold. But as you mentioned, we have our gold miners ETFs. They're 2X. NUGT is a bull fund. DUST, Dust, is the bear fund. And then we have the junior gold miners that, they're smaller cap companies, tend to be, historically a little bit more volatile than, the larger gold mining stocks. We have 2X funds. JNUG is the bull fund, and JDST is the bear fund. And we've seen the gold mining stocks and equities kind of rally, like I said, delayed rally behind the spot price of gold. But we saw today, especially with gold and the gold mining stocks, a pretty strong rally, around 2 to 215. These are short-term trading tools. Last week after the pretty strong rally over a couple weeks, we saw some larger outflows in JNUG, which is the 2X junior gold miners fund. And that's really short-term traders taking profit from the run-up that happened over the past couple weeks. But we've seen a lot of activity, especially in the bull products today, JNUG and NUGT.
Oh, man, it's pretty remarkable seeing these percentages. I was jumping through the charts as you were talking there. And folks, if you're out there listening, I mean, when gold hits these levels, every gold miner, of course, is their own entity, their own business. But sometimes, and it's interesting, Elliot, especially the miners, right? You start approaching these lofty levels, and sometimes, man, these companies are pulling gold out of the ground, and every single time gold is going up $50, $100, it's just going right to the bottom line of some of these companies. So it's amazing when you get these types of runs, folks, in the gold contract that, yeah, you might see some huge accelerations, and, you know, we're seeing it today. Nugget up almost 10%, and looking at the juniors as well. They are rocking and rolling. Now, speaking of rocking and rolling, we got to talk about some of the Magnificent Seven. I know you guys have a variety of ETFs. You got the single stock ETFs, of course, and those are on fire. Microsoft right now, you're up about 1%. I'm looking at up another $4, approaching all-time highs. That stock holding out so well. Apple, been struggling a little bit, but they got some news with Google this week. And then, of course, NVIDIA, the poster boy. But for those investors that are looking for, you know, whether it's individual ETF equities, and exposure to the Magnificent Seven as this run, you know, there's a lot of people out there talking about, you know, it's tough to call it the beginning of the run right now from where we've come. But boy, we are at the forefront of some pretty remarkable technology, and the stocks are paying attention. If you could just talk about, you know, direction, the outstanding ETFs you guys have, and how you've gotten into some of those around the Magnificent Seven as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, it might be currently the Magnificent Six right now with Tesla's performance this year, but right. We'll go with the seven.
Sure.
But that being said, yes, we do offer leverage and inverse single stock ETFs. So these are providing, on the bull side, 1.5 daily exposure to these individual names. We have it across Apple, Amazon, Google, Microsoft, NVIDIA, and Tesla. So we have six out of the seven, with the exception of we're missing Meta of our suite. And then on the inverse side, we have their single inverse, more used for intermediate, short-term hedging, concentrated position. But yeah, as you mentioned, you know, we're seeing Microsoft trading to all-time highs, you know, kind of seeing it being perceived as, you know, one of the AI leaders, and a recent rotation out of NVIDIA. We've seen a lot of action in our, you know, our single stock bull Microsoft fund, MSFU is the ticker. And we've seen some key hiring for in-house AI capabilities. Actually, a couple announcements today coming out of Microsoft. And with Apple, you know, their AI efforts have really yet to materialize. But earlier this week, we saw a report of Apple licensing Google's Gemini AI to power the iPhone AI. So, you know, their AI for Apple is kind of yet to materialize, but they're making strides and efforts, you know, to partner with some of the leaders like Google and Alphabet. And we do have, again, single stocks for both those products. But one of the more exciting things, you know, in kind of the Magnificent Seven space is the GTC Global AI Conference that NVIDIA has been hosting this week. NVIDIA has been a very popular name last year, running into this year. And we've seen a lot of action in our NVIDIA Bull single stock ETF, NVDU, you know, and really some exciting stuff, you know, coming out of the conference, you know, kind of looking at their goal to, you know, really become a turnkey full stack provider of proprietary AI, you know, factories, where they're both, you know, in the hardware space, but also the software space as a provider in AI. And, you know, outside of if the single stock space is not a place, you know, you're really looking for, we actually, our newest fund, we've launched a concentrated Qs bull and bear ETF. The bull ETF is 2X, the bear is single inverse. And that's taking the highest market cap weighted companies within the NASDAQ 100. So as you can imagine right now, that's made up of all the Magnificent Seven names. But we've recently launched that, and it's a great way to trade short term if you're looking to trade not the single stocks, but you know, the concentrated, you know, NASDAQ 100, which just happens to be you know, the Magnificent Seven at the moment.
Right. And I was pulling those symbols up as you were talking about it. Those are QQQU and QQQD. And if you don't think Tesla has the legs, folks, they got the bear on Tesla as well. So you don't got to do all sides of it. Elliot, I appreciate the time, man, coming on the program. Great discussion on a busy day. And we look forward to having you back on TFNN.
Thank you for having me. Looking forward to it.
Always a pleasure. Folks, check it out. Don't forget, you can always find out about Direction products. Click on that Direction banner on the front page of TFNN.com, and we'll be right back, folks.
Many trading newsletters attempt to focus on a narrow set of equities or commodities. While this works for some, it oftentimes misses many opportunities that possess huge gain potential. But how is an independent trader supposed to scan the entire market looking for these hidden opportunities? One simple answer, the opening call newsletter. Basil Chapman, developer of the Chapman Wave trading methodology, has been trading the markets for longer than most trading influencers have been alive. And over that time, he has honed his methodology in order to accurately call movements in a wide range of equities, from semiconductors to uranium to key indices and so much more. Basil is old school, taking the time to educate the trader while also giving his insights into key indices, selective stocks, and more. Opening Call subscribers also receive access to dozens of Basil's educational live streams that can be accessed at any time for your edification. All first-time subscribers receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. So ignore the pop trading influencers and start learning time-tested technical analysis.
Steve Rhodes started his trading career as a student almost 20 years ago, and the student has now become the master. Steve won the prestigious Timer of the Year award in 2018 and barely missed that mark again in 2019. Finishing at number 2 for the year. An amazing accomplishment. Steve Rhodes is committed to sharing his techniques and knowledge with anyone who wants to learn. And he shares his vast amount of trading knowledge every day in his Mastering Probability newsletter. Steve's award-winning newsletter, Mastering Probability, is delivered every trading day with updates throughout the afternoon. Sign up for Steve's market newsletter, Mastering Probability, and you'll receive access to 7 of Steve's educational webinars absolutely free. At TFNN, all our newsletters come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have absolutely nothing to worry about. Visit TFNN.com and try Mastering Probability 30 days risk-free today. TFNN, educating investors.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions.
If you're looking for potential trading setups in the stock market, then Rocket Equities and Options Report is a newsletter you should try. Tommy O'Brien delivers options and equity trades when the markets present them using a combination of fundamentals and technicals. Sign up for Rocket Equities and Options Report today with a 30-day money-back guarantee so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors. For traders who crave risk, Direction's daily leveraged and inverse ETFs provide opportunities to magnify short-term perspectives with up to 3x a daily leverage, utilize bull and bear funds from both sides of the trade, and trade through rapidly changing markets. These are highly leveraged ETFs with daily resetting designed for short-term trading, not long-term investing. Whether you're a bull or a bear, you choose the Direction. For up-to-date pricing and performance, go to direction.com. Investing in the funds involves significant risk and should only be utilized by investors who understand the impact of leverage and actively monitor their portfolio. They are not designed to track the underlying index or security for more than a day. Before investing, carefully consider a fund's investment objective, risk, charges, and expenses contained in the prospectus available at direction.com. Read carefully. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
This program is brought to you by Vista Gold, traded on the NYSE American and TSX under the symbol VGZ.
Tom O'Brien!
Welcome back, folks. We get the S&Ps right now up by 42 points. How about the NASDAQ 100 pushing 206 points to the positive, 18,477. We are just off all-time highs. And how about the Dow? We're making a run for it, man. We are making a run. Am I going to get to say 40,000 on the air? We got 19 minutes left. I'm going to do the 4 o'clock update as well. And we got the futures 26 points away on that last bar, 39,942 right now. We're up by a full percentage point on the Dow. And how about the Russell? Up by 2.1%. Bitcoin joining the party, up by $1,200 at $65,885. Crude backing off a bit at $81.35. Boy, one of the stories is going to be the dollar, right? Look at that. Still dropping at $103.39. Appreciate Elliot coming on the air with us in a great discussion. And how about those gold miners, man, right? You check out gold, up $28 to $21.87. And boy, yeah, you take a look at some of those and you add, number one, the miners. And like I mentioned, folks, sometimes, right? Imagine you're running a company, okay? You build that company on the premise that you're digging gold out of the ground at a certain price point, okay? When these companies are operating, they can't plan that they're digging that out of the ground at $2,200 an ounce, okay? But what happens is that their cost, yes, we're in an inflationary environment. I'm sure mining costs have gone up, but we've just risen in a dramatic fashion. So sometimes these miners, I mean, I'm just going to cherry pick here. Yeah, look at, I cherry pick. Harmony up by 8.2% today alone. Hecla, look at this run from $4 to $4.40, right? 7% in an instant. Some of these miners, man, every single dollar that gold goes up right now is going straight to the bottom line. It's not costing them more money between yesterday and today to get that gold out of the ground. And meanwhile, the product that they are mining is just going up gangbusters right now, as we got dollar weakness, we got gold strength, and yeah, you check out some of those, man. JNUG, 9.7%. Nugget shares, 8.4% to the upside. Pretty remarkable, to put it lightly. And, you know, again, Ellie was talking about daily investment vehicles, right? So what you do want to pay attention to, folks, and we sent out a great article and an email to our customer base. When was that? Within the last month or so? I'm trying to figure out when that was. When was that? February 27th or so? Yeah, so about 3 weeks ago, we sent out a great email working with the fine people at Direction. And what they were talking about in that article was inside leveraged and inverse exchange-traded funds, an exploration of the risks and potential benefits, okay? And on the heels of that conversation, I said, you know what? I'm going to take a look at that real quick because it's pretty cool. If you miss this at all, folks, okay, and we sent it out to our list, shoot me a quick email at tommy@tfnn.com. I'll send you this information. It's right available. I'm looking at the Direction website. They put out outstanding information. And what it goes over, okay, which is why you want to approach these vehicles as daily investment vehicles when you're dealing with leveraged ETFs, okay, because they behave in a much different manner on a longer-term basis than you may anticipate. And I could spend a whole hour on this show, on this article, folks, but what is awesome is they show you in this article, and like I said, if you didn't get it, folks, please send me an email. I'll shoot it over to you, okay? Because what they go through here, which is so cool, is how the inverse and just leveraged ETFs react according to what the underlying index or you know, stocks or gold miners, right? What the benchmark does, and then what your ETF will do depending on, and they lay out each scenario. They say, what happens if the market rises steadily? Well, what's going to happen to your 3x fund versus the cumulative index value over that time? What happens if the market is declining steadily? Tell me how a leveraged or inverse ETF is going to behave if I get into that vehicle when the market is declining on a steady basis. And then tell me if I enter a leveraged ETF in a market that is flat yet volatile, show me some scenarios of how I can anticipate what can happen. And what happens is, folks, sometimes, right, you got the index cumulative return of zero. And if you're in a flat and choppy market, sometimes you might pull a negative return on some of these ETFs. So it's something you want to be aware of. I know we got a lot of traders out there that are into these. If you didn't get that email, if you didn't check it out, if you just can't find it, send me an email at tommy@tfnn.com. I'll send you that email. I'll direct you a direction because it's a great article. We always talk about it, but I don't think enough people really understand how those leveraged ETFs can react in either markets that are going up steadily going down steadily, or if they're just chopping around. They're not chopping around today, man. They are going up as gold markets going up, indices going up, dollar going down, and let's check in on yields. We got the 10-year right now. I mean, not a huge move for the dollar reaction, right? 1.1013 right now. We're positive by 8 ticks, but boy, when you correlate to the dollar, yeah, it's not stopping. 103.42 right now on the dollar index, and that's putting a bid on gold, to say the least. Let's check in on the dollar yen. How's that reacting? Yeah, that's going to maybe help the Bank of Japan a little bit, right? I was talking to our man Teddy Kegstad this morning when we were just up here at about 151.81, and boy, you talk about a pullback on a longer-term basis, all right, for you gold bulls, you want to pay attention to the dollar yen as well. 2022, we approach 152. 2023 in November, we approach 152, and I'm not saying it's going to hold, folks, okay? We know the market can do some funky things, to put it lightly, but it is interesting. We're right back at that level. The Bank of Japan, they hike interest rates for the first time since 2007, and what does the market do? The market says, yeah, but you're just hiking once, and you're not going to hike again for an extended period of time because you're very worried over there, and that's the case, and we got the yen pushing 150, 182. Think about where the gold contract is, though, with the yen trading at 151.15. You ever get some real pullbacks there? You get a pullback in the dollar like we're getting today. Higher prices possible in that gold contract. I know anything's possible, but when you look at some of the currencies and what's going on, you look at the yen in particular, the gold, very volatile in terms of where we are with the dollar yen, and we got gold pushing all-time highs even with the yen at 151 and change, which is remarkable. All right, let's check in on some of, yeah, the magnificent. I mean, when's it going to go six? I guess it's already six. Don't tell Elon that. He might kick you off X, I kid. Tesla joining the fun, up by 2.6% today, 175.86. Boy, Microsoft just doesn't stop, though. 424, up by another 0.6%. Now, Apple's having quite a week for itself on the heels of the potential deal that they're discussing with Google and Gemini. We touched on that in the interview with Elliot as well. Apple shares up almost $2 at 178 on the dot right now, 1.1% to the upside right now. Yeah, and let's talk about a few other stories that we had this morning. How about Intel? News comes out, Intel, they're getting $8.5 billion from the CHIPS Act. They can potentially take another $11 billion in loans. So you're talking about between $8 and $20 billion, that number. That's the thrust that you see higher in the pre-market. And sometime buy the rumor, sell the news, you spike higher, and then everyone says, yeah, that's not coming due just yet, as in that's not going to pay dividends just yet for shareholders. You spike all the way from 44 to 41.41. Intel flat on a day where we got markets making record highs across the board, and they get $8.5 billion from the CHIPS Act. Be careful on Intel, man. They should be having a strong day today. AMD had similar moves with Intel. You spike higher, you pull back to 174. They're still negative by 1.2%. NVIDIA has their conference going on. You had their CEO, Jensen Huang. He was speaking at the end of Monday. They come out with a new chip. What is it, 208 billion resistors? 208 billion resistors. I mean, the chip's pretty big if you saw some pictures of it. Okay, it looks like the size of a small notebook, as in it's not one of these tiny chips. Okay, the definition of a chip is changing, but still 208 billion resistors. I think the last one they had, the H100, was somewhere in the range of 80 billion or something like that. Going to be twice as fast. And yeah, the future is changing right in front of our eyes. And like I said to Elliot again, not exactly the beginning, okay? This run has been going on for some time. It's the reason why we have some of these markets accelerating on a daily basis, almost for a period of 3 or 4 months. I mean, you look at this run in the S&Ps. Let me just look at it in a SPY to get some of those notations off the chart. I can't even see a downtick, man. I was talking to our man Kevin Hinks this morning, and I was remarking on, we're up 26% from where we were in October, and we're probably pushing almost 30%, 28, 29, something from where we were this morning. A lot of that on the heels of NVIDIA. You back up NVIDIA shares, okay? NVIDIA, where'd we go to? In October, we are at 400. You just went to 974. But there's a lot of promise here. And we are 6 months into the world changing. And when you think about the productivity gains, okay, that's what you want to hang your hat on, man. Productivity gains and what one person can do, what a small team can do. And so, yes, you can have wage growth if productivity gains are keeping up with the wages, that will help everything. And so, yeah, we could be at the forefront. Pretty remarkable. Dow, maybe not just yet. We pair some of those gains. You just pull back about 100 points from that spike high, 39,974. We'll see. Stay tuned. We'll be coming back after the break for one more segment. Don't go away.
The stock market is a delicate interconnecting web of commodities, equities, and trader psychology. When one string of the web is pulled, it has a ripple effect across the broader market. This is where opportunity lies. But how are you to gather all of this information into one cohesive model when you're already spending your energy looking for any possible trade opportunities? Luckily, you don't have to worry about that, as Tom O'Brien has brought all important market news to you in one single newsletter, Market Insights. Market Insights provides a daily overview of what's happening in the indexes, bonds, gold, and more. Follow along with Tom daily as he analyzes the components that affect the overall movement of the stock market, giving insight into how each one plays either a bullish or bearish role. Tom also analyzes specific equities that he believes has the potential to make huge returns, and his track record proves his analysis right. All first-time subscribers receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what are you waiting for? Don't let the market leave you in the dust.
In the world of trading, only a few names stand out like Larry Pesavento. A pro's pro with over 50 years of experience, Larry has seen it all. A former Chicago Mercantile Exchange member, Larry has authored 10 books and trained over 1,000 traders with his unmatched expertise. Introducing Fibonacci 24/7, Larry Pesavento's daily trading service that turns the complexity of markets into opportunities. Published every Sunday, receive a comprehensive report packed with detailed commentary, charts, and videos that illuminate the patterns shaping the markets, with updates throughout the week exclusively for subscribers. Whether through charts or videos, Larry's analysis is your roadmap to navigating the markets. You can sign up now at TFNN.com for just $97. And with all TFNN newsletters backed by a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to risk. For all the details, visit TFNN.com. You'll find Fibonacci 24/7 right under the newsletters tab.
The reality is that navigating financial markets can be risky. Markets can be chaotic and difficult to understand. Having the latest market advice can help you turn this chaos into a key for creating winning trades. At TFNN, we understand that it can be hard to find reliable market news. That's why each of our market experts offers their very own market newsletter. A must-have tool for every trader out there striving to find an edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets so you can analyze the market before you trade. Try any of our great newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Just visit the newsletters tab on the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN. Educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Welcome back, folks, and markets are making a run for it, man. You got the Dow up 399 points, 39,934. We might get it the way this market's moving, man. Absolutely remarkable that we're approaching 40,000 in the Dow. NASDAQ 100, catch a little bit of a lift off that pullback. We're at 18,465. And how about the Russell, as I mentioned, up by almost 2%. S&P is going to close in record territory. We're sitting at 5280 right now. And backing up, let's check in on a dollar before we do a little. Yeah, dollar sitting at about 103.40 in that gold contract, just under all-time highs of 21.86. Now, some of the takeaways from the Fed, okay? Like I said at the beginning of the show, Bloomberg just does an outstanding job on days like today especially. Quantitative tightening, they're staying where they are, man. $95 billion rolling off the balance sheet, $60 billion in treasuries, $30 billion in mortgage-backed securities, okay? They lift the forecast of where they see rates settling over the long term. Keep this one in your head, folks, because it's not a small move. to tell the market that on the long term, rates are not going back to 2.5. They're going back to at least 2.6. And I imagine that there is the possibility that that number even goes higher. The change implies rates will need to stay higher for longer in the future. A lot of people have been talking about it, and finally they make a change for their benchmark rate on a longer term basis. Now, why are they making that change? Well, part of the reason why might be that they keep the rate, the PCE, okay, at 2.4 for 2024, but core PCE rising to 2.6. Inflation is not coming down, man. We are in a different environment from where we were prior to the pandemic. I think the Fed has finally acknowledged that. Their median forecast for 2025 rising to 3.9% from 3.6. They take one cut out of the picture for 2025. But is that the beginning? Is that the beginning of a trend? What if they take two cuts out? What if on a longer term basis, they go up to 2.75 from 2.6? What if they go up to three, right? 2.6 is the first move. We'll see where we go from there. Folks, thanks so much for tuning in on a busy day. I appreciate your time. We got the S&Ps up by 40 points. I'm coming back for the 4 o'clock update. And then I look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock in the morning as well. Have a great night. Have a safe night, folks. We'll see you tomorrow. Thanks so much.